NBA players getting arrested isn't nothing new. We've seen this happen plenty of times since the NBA started. But in this video, we're going to look at NBA players who got arrested in 2020. But before we look at the actual NBA players, let's talk about Kareem Abdul-Jabbar's son Adam getting arrested first. Supposedly, he got into an argument with his neighbor after he told him to take the trash out. And after that, he got mad and stabbed him multiple times. This is his neighbor saying his side of the story.
I'm going to stick a knife through your teeth. And I said, really? Because I thought he was only joking. He's, you know, I've known the kid for a long time. I turned and he was on me. I thought he was punching me, but he actually had a knife. After the fourth punch, I felt a very sharp pain and noticed blood coming out of me.
Because of this, he got charged with 3 felony counts of assault with a deadly weapon, 1 felony count of carrying a dirk or dagger, and 3 enhancements of inflicting great bodily injury over his alleged role in the incident. If he's convicted on all counts, he faces up to 10 years in prison. According to his lawyer, his neighbor was the one who actually started it, and Adam was actually the one who called the cops. I don't know what's the real reason why he stabbed him, but the fact this happened is crazy. I would have never thought Kareem Abdul-Jabbar's son would ever be in a situation like this. You normally don't see Hall of Famers' children get into these kind of things. I'm also surprised he never played ball too. He probably could have been a good player. Malik Beasley was arrested this year for marijuana possession and concealing stolen property. Cops came to his house after someone called them saying someone from that area told him to leave the house while pointing a gun at them. When they came to his house, they found a 12-gauge shotgun, a handgun, and an automatic rifle that matched the description. They also found marijuana at his house as well. When he got arrested, he was released from jail shortly after with no charges that day, but later on ended up getting charged with 5th-degree drug possession and threat of violence from his initial arrest. This isn't the first time he got into something too. Just last year, he got into an altercation with an NFL player over a girl. I don't know the whole story, but it seems like his girl cheated, and he went to confront him because of it. But as you can see, it didn't turn out in his favor. He ended up losing the altercation, and he's not even with that girl anymore. You should never ever get mad at another man over a girl. If you do, you're a simp. But after he got arrested, I thought it would affect the Timberwolves re-signing him, but it didn't. He ended up signing with them again the other day. I think that was a great move by them. Before the season ended, he was balling with the Wolves. He averaged nearly 21 points, 5 boards, and 2 assists, while being extremely efficient. He shot 47% from the field and 42% from 3, making 3.5 a game. Not too long ago, last month, Terrence Davis was arrested in my city for allegedly assaulting a woman at a Midtown luxury high-rise. The woman he allegedly assaulted happened to be his girlfriend. She said he punched her in the face multiple times and broke her phone. I don't know if this is true, but I hope it isn't. It doesn't matter how much your girl gets you mad, you should never resort to violence. But who knows if this really happened? Girls lie all the time, especially on athletes. People I know college careers got ruined because of a girl lying on them about something. Hopefully that's not the case with this though. But it looks like he's gonna be good. He should get his player option picked up despite his domestic assault case. He played amazing in his role last season. He averaged 7.5 points, 3 boards, and 1 assist, shooting 45% from the field, nearly 39% from 3, and 86% from the line in only 16 minutes a game. This earned him second team all rookie at the end of the season. Kevin Porter Jr. was arrested a couple of weeks ago on gun charges. The police found a loaded gun in his car after responding to a car crash he was involved in. He was issued a summons for a petty offense, then released shortly after. I don't blame him for keeping it on him, because it's dangerous in these streets. Anything can happen, so it's good to have protection on you. Last month, Kevin Porter Jr. also made news after posting a black screen on Instagram with a caption saying, "You ever wish to see the end of your time?" Many people thought he was thinking about committing suicide because he said this. But after that, he shut down those rumors after he said on Twitter that he's fine. He's already been through his worst times, so it can't get worse. Hopefully he's not just saying that though and everything is really good. He played pretty good in his role with the Cavs this season. He averaged 10 points, 3 rebounds, and 2 assists, playing 23 minutes a game. Shannon Brown was arrested in May after he was accused of firing a rifle at 2 people who were looking at homes for sale in Atlanta. When he was arrested, he immediately bonded out after. He told police the reason why he did that was because he thought the couple was trying to break into his home. Shannon Brown isn't in the league no more, but when he was, he had a solid career. He played in the league for almost 10 years, and he has career averages of 7 points, 2 rebounds, 1 assist, and he also won 2 chips with the Lakers back in 09 and 010. Another retired NBA player who got arrested this year was Gerald Wilkins. Many of you guys may not know him, but Gerald is Dominique Wilkins' younger brother and was a role player for most of his career. He played on four teams, but his best moments in the league was with the Knicks. He was arrested on battery and trespassing charges back in August. Those were all the NBA players who got arrested this year. Let me know what you think about these players getting arrested in the comments. And if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe for more vids. Peace.